I'm back out here again, where I was beachcombing last time. There was something that I found yesterday, and I kind of dismissed it as being some scrap metal. Some further investigation and somebody mentioned something. I'm on a Facebook page, and somebody mentioned something, and I thought, hang on a second, that I started looking at another story that they'd mentioned about a thing called Beaufort Dyke, which is like a marine trench between Ireland and Scotland, where a lot of munitions that were captured during the Second World War from the Germans were dumped. So and a lot of unused munitions on the, you know, from the British side, so things like 500-pound bombs and that kind of thing were all dumped into this trench in the Irish Sea. So I saw this thing yesterday, and like I say, this little bit of research today has prompted me to come back to see if I can find it. The tide is supposedly on its way out again, but it looks really far in, so I don't know whether I'm going to get as far as I want to get today, and whether I'm going to find this thing again. I don't know, we're going to find out. So hang tight, and let's go for a wander and see if we can find it. Well, it would seem, if you can hear me above the wind noise, that we are currently cut off from where we want to be, because the tide is just a little bit too far in. It's like I said, it's on its way out, so I'm just going to have a wander around here and see if we can find anything of any interest. Washed up on the shoreline here. Like I say, the sea's only just there now, and on the last hunt it was a lot further out, so and we're just coming up to 4 o'clock, so I think we're about maybe an hour too early, which is a shame, because I don't know if I can kill an hour searching here, but we'll see what happens. Well, that there's some size of log that's washed up. There's my size 11 feet for reference. Yeah, well, the tide is on its way out, so I'm going to try and work my way along and get to where I need to be. It's just that it's a little unnerving and just a tad dangerous being so close to the sea when it's a bit rough. But we'll see how far we can get. Well, this is the first thing I've found. There you go. A boat hook. It's even got made in Italy on it. So somebody's homemade boat hook that they've lost. I'm not going to keep that, so. Right, well, I got to where I wanted to be. I got past the tide going out there. It was a little bit hairy at one stage, but we made it safely nonetheless. So now I've actually got about an hour or so now to kill. We might just be able to find this item that we've come looking for today. So I'm going to get to it. If I find anything along the way, obviously I'll show you. That's from a teapot spout. Probably a teapot lid, possibly even from the same teapot. another stopper. Got another one there. And I'm going to stop because I saw that. Look at that now. Blue top stoneware. I wonder if that's some sort of ink. I think it's too big to be a ginger beer, but nice enough. Well, it would seem on this occasion, on this little search, that the item that I was looking for has disappeared for the moment, as is the way with the sea and the tides. It brings things and then takes them away again. I'm just wandering back now to back to the car, and we'll keep our eyes peeled, see if we see it, and I'll let you know if we do. Although I don't think we're going to find it today, not on this hunt anyway. I should have picked it up yesterday, but then again, I had no idea what it was or what I thought it might be. So anyway, you live and learn, don't you? So they say, anyway. Right, I shall keep going, and I'll come back to you if we find anything else of any interest. Here's an odd item. Oh, here, let's see what this is. Oh, is that a jellyfish? Ooh. What on earth? Yeah, that's a jellyfish. Well, would you look at that? Dead. I'm certainly not going to touch it. Ooh! With my hands anyway. I'd say that's dead. From what I understand, once they're out of the water, they start to dissolve, as it were, which is quite an unpleasant way to die, but yeah, without seawater, the jellyfish can't live, so, yeah. Okay, well, like I say, going to keep heading home, or heading back to the car now. And, I'm a little bit annoyed about what I was looking for, and it not being here, but, like I say, it's the way it goes. More stoppers. I think this one might be wood. It's called Lignum Vitae. We're gonna have to dry this out. These are quite rare. Obviously, if they're wood, they don't last as long as vulcanized rubber. So I'm certain that's Lignum Vitae wood. Is that one? There's another one, but there's a rather large bone. I'm certain that's not going to be human. I'm certain. If there's anybody that's an expert out there that can tell me, I'm going to take it with. If there's anybody that can tell me for certain, I think it's animal. There's lots of animal bones out here, so I'm certain it's going to be an animal bone. Okay, well, if anybody's any idea, that'd be rather macabre, wouldn't it? Well, I'm not going to show you it, but there was a couple of tents that I saw yesterday. And this is quite an exposed location, but there's a couple of tents, and I saw them yesterday, and they looked abandoned, but. Anyway, I've just been over there today and shouted hello, and there's actually a chap in one of the tents at the moment. He says he's not homeless. I asked him if he was okay, if there's anything he needed, but he's all good. Apparently he's lots of friends and family, and I'm not going to say any more than that, really. Like I say, I'm not going to show the full location of where I am, because obviously it's his private life. So one of those things.
he seemed happy enough when I was talking to him, so yeah, I think just for the moment we'll leave him to it, and maybe every now and again we'll check on him, see if there's anything he wants or needs. So alright, well, I will I'm heading back to the car now. As you can see, I have to ford my way through some rather fast flowing water here. All this rain we've had over the last couple of days, then the water has to go somewhere, and this is one of the locations where it goes. So yeah, I will see you soon. I might do a little roundup just at home, but we didn't get anything over exciting. You see, we've got this bit of rather fast flowing water here, so let's see if I can just find a little flatter, shallower area to get through it, and I will see you soon. I was kind of taken aback with the guy in the tent. I know it happens all over the world, even in places like Helensburgh it happens, obviously. Yeah, I'm not going to go too far into his personal life, because I don't think this is the right forum to do that. But what I will say is that I will check up on him as regularly as I can, just make sure that he's okay and that he's got everything that he needs. So yeah, because I think that's about all I can do, really. He seemed happy enough. He didn't seem cold, or his tent was obviously dry. He, you know, like I say, he seemed perfectly happy. He had a few other bits there. He's keeping his little camp tidy. So fair play to him if that's what he wants to do. I mean, we all make our own choices in life, you know. So there you go. That was a nice. Reasonably nice day anyway. I'm just going to quickly go through the bits and bobs anyway for you. Vertebra. I'm assuming it's an animal vertebra. I've looked at a model human skeleton today, and this section in the middle here is literally half that size of a human bone, so it's certainly not human. I wasn't sure, but I'm probably guessing maybe pig or goat or sheep, even. Could be even sheep. I'm sure somebody out there might know anyway from that. So yeah, so there's that. There's the bottleneck in blue. Shame it wasn't a complete bottle, but you can actually see where the blue glaze has run inside there. It was dipped into the blue glaze before firing. But yeah, that was a nice thing to find. Don't think that's been a ginger beer, because this side is too steep, as it were. It's too straight. They normally sort of flare out. So anyway, I'm sure a lot of you have seen a ginger beer bottle before, so. Yeah, I'm guessing that's probably maybe an ink bottle of some description. Although I've not seen a blue one yet, but you never know. And we got several stoppers again. Again, one with the deep hole in there in the middle. And these are all just plain, unbranded, or the brands have worn off, to be perfectly honest with you. I probably had something on it at some stage. And as did that one. But yeah, rolling about in the sea for 70 to 100 years has polished them up and worn everything off. This, I was right, this is the wooden stopper. And this would have been like one of these screw stoppers. But again, it's worn away over time, rolling about in the surf. But before they had these... These are what they call vulcanite. It's a form of vulcanized rubber that was invented in, I think it's 1846, by the Goodyear Company. These became popular in the 1870s to stopper bottles, and they lasted right up to the 1970s by all accounts. But prior to that, they used wooden screw stoppers.
from roughly around about the 1840s, not 1940s, 1840s, they used a screw stop, a wooden screw stopper. So these are rare things to find, because as you can imagine, being wood and in the sea, they tend to rot away quite quickly or get worn away quite quickly. But yeah, I've only ever found one other stopper before that's made of wood, and the wood is called lignum vitae. It's a very, very hard wood. So there you go. And like I say in every video, if you enjoyed that, then leave a thumbs up, leave a comment down below as well. I answer every comment, or I certainly try to answer every comment, and I think I do answer every comment anyway. But yeah, hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you on the next hunt. All right, bye for now.